I'm going to walk you through using Kindle Create on a Microsoft Word document to create a beautiful interior for your Kindle ebook. Please note, this video is specific to starting from a Word file. If you have a PDF file and you want to maintain your print layout, choose the second option and let Kindle Create walk you through converting your PDF. To begin, I am going to upload my Word file. Let's see how Kindle Create interpreted the original formatting from this Microsoft Word document. This result is the same as you would have seen after submitting directly to KDP. But with Kindle Create, you can see immediately that there's no table of contents and we've only been able to find 5 sections. That's not what we were intending. Let's use Kindle Create to format the book so that it looks the way we intend. First, let's start with the table of contents. Kindle Create can automatically put this together. Here's how. Let's rerun the chapter detection function. Here you can see a list of potential chapter titles. Kindle Create tries to find every possible chapter title and let you remove the extra ones, rather than forcing you to hunt for the ones that it missed. To see a chapter page, click anything in the list. If it's correct, do nothing. Leave the entry checked. If it's not really a chapter title, unselect it and Kindle Create will return the formatting to the original look. Now, let's add additional structure for this book. Elements help you identify the structural portions of your book: chapter title, book title, preface, dedication, etc. The way the elements feature works is that you identify the structural components and tag them from this list. For example, I am choosing Pride and Prejudice to tag as the book title element. To see an example or learn more, hover over the italicized I next to each element. Now I'm going to tag the author name. With my chapters properly identified, I can change the styles. By default, Kindle Create sets your book to the theme we've named Modern, but you can apply any theme to get a different feel for your book. This previewer gives you a clear idea of what customers will see. You can review your table of contents and the body of your book and make sure you like how it will look on a variety of devices. Click the X to exit out of preview. I want to save my work so that I could return to my project later. When you save your file within Kindle Create, it creates a folder to store the content needed for the working file. When I reopen the Kindle Create file, it will open my book along with Kindle Create. All of my changes have been saved and I can resume work. Now, let's add other elements to give this book some style. To apply a drop cap, you can highlight the first character or place the cursor at the beginning of the first paragraph. Kindle Create will default to creating a drop cap of 3 lines and the first character. However, if you want to customize this, you can do so by changing the size in the Apply Drop Cap settings. You can also change the number of characters that a drop cap applies to. Oops, I picked the wrong element. No problem. I can undo to clear this formatting and reapply the correct element. There we go. Kindle Create also has a find function. 2 great uses for find are 1, to find chapter titles and apply the drop cap, and 2, to find separators and tag. Tagging specific elements will format them into your chosen theme style. Theme changes will update the style of everything you've tagged, including the separators, as we see here. Once I'm satisfied with my layout, I can package my book for submission to Kindle. The package feature makes sure that my book is stored in the right format for publishing to Kindle. It also updates the Kindle Create working file to match. I'll submit the .kpf file to Kindle and have a professionally styled Kindle book in my library. Thanks for watching and happy publishing.